to the point where they have finally made the decision to become husband and wife. If there's anyone in attendance here today who can show just cause why this very attractive couple should not be joined as husband and wife, could you please speak now or forever hold your peace? So I'm going to start with this handsome lad right here, and I'm going to give you these two rings. Yep. And in a moment, when I walk away, I'm going, oh, we dropped him on the floor already. When I walk away in a moment, we're going to do what's called warming the rings. I'm going to ask you to hold them between both of your hands and hold them tightly. And just for a few moments, close your eyes and make it as though there's a crystal ball in your hands. His eyes are already closed. And see all the wonderful things that are going to happen to Kathleen and Joe. His eyes are closed. All the wonderful things that will happen over the next 50 plus years to them as they embark today upon their amazing adventure as husband and wife. And then, when you are done having your few moments of silent reflection, you will hand the rings over to the pretty girl beside you, and then she will hand them over to the... I said, you're going to hand those rings to the pretty girl beside you. And he said, that's Kathleen's mom. Thank you. Joe, from this day forward.
Joe, from this day forward.
I promise you these things.
I promise you these things.
For better or for worse.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
And I will love and respect you always.
And I will love and respect you always.
Very nicely done. Some of you may have heard the expression tying the knot when people refer to marriage. Ever wonder why? It's an actual, real expression from the way weddings used to be held. A length of rope would be tied around the bride and groom's hands. It was known as hand fasting. The bride and groom had to leave the rope attached to their hands with them bonded together, tied together, for 24 hours. Only the day after they are married were they allowed to remove the rope, and then and only then were they actually, truly husband and wife. And now please join your left hands as well. Notice that as their hands extend and join between them, they form the infinity symbol between them. This refers to their eternal, undying, never-ending love for each other. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong, and holding on to yours as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will help you to create and build and hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. These are the hands that will wipe tears from your eyes. Tears of sorrow, and as in today, tears of joy. Lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same tenderness with just a touch. And now, please gaze into the eyes of your future husband and place that ring halfway onto his ring finger. And now, please, as you look into his eyes, repeat after me. Joe, I give you this ring.
Joe, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
My love and my faithfulness.
My love and my faithfulness.
As this ring has no end.
As this ring has no end.
Neither shall my love for you.
Neither shall my love for you.
I take you to be my wife.
I take you to be my wife.
This day and every day.
This day and every day.
Just like that. There's your example. It takes one to get things going.
Exactly. And,
yeah,
right?
So thank you.
You're welcome.
Bring your camera, bring your phone. One last thing we need to do, and we all need to do it together. Does everyone here in this room right now approve of this marriage, and do you all give it your blessing? If you do, oh, very nice. If you do, please answer in a loud voice now, we do!
We do!
Kathleen, Joe, they say, marry the one you love, and then love the one you marry. You have just about completed the first half of that time-honored tradition, and now you are about to leave here and go do the second half for the rest of your lives. When we met to plan today's wedding, we talked about what would happen when it was time for their first kiss. And rather than have it be the three of us, we decided that it might be nice if it was only the two of them. And now, by the power granted me, by the state of New Hampshire, I pronounce you husband and wife. Joseph, you may kiss your wife.